Hello pilots and welcome back to Flight Academy Season 7, brought to you by Out of Arc Gaming. As always, my name is Phil, and today we have Game 9, which is the final game of Group 1 to decide who is going to make it into our top 4. Just a reminder of the standings, Wes currently has 7 points. Benji, who has played all of his games, also has 7 points, and I am currently sat on 3 points. So this could make a bit of a headache after the end of this game, but we'll see how it goes. But joining me in the virtual booth once again, we have...
I'm Grand but non-Inquisitor, it's James.
Hey James, welcome along. I need to get you Flags of Empire sometimes, just to see how it goes for you. You never know, you might go to the dark side.
I mean, if I were to do it, I definitely want to use the Force users because they have some very fun abilities, like the Grand Inquisitor. Well, actually, all of the Inquisitors have very interesting abilities.
They are some cool ships, I'm not going to lie. I mean, they just look cool as well. But let's quickly run down the list. Did you want to remind us what Wes has brought?
Yes. So Wes has brought Adigalia with marksmanship, R4P17, and the calibrated laser targeting,
which we saw to great effect in the last round. So if you haven't seen that,
it adds up.
It really does. And on the other side, with a very similar but flipped ability, we've got myself with the Grand Inquisitor in the TIE Advance B1 with instinctive aim, predictive shot. That was a great barrel roll. Marksmanship, fire control system, and proton rockets.
Yeah, barreling just out of that bullseye.
Wow.
So just to clarify, because they have very similar abilities. Adigalia goes, you're at range one. I will tell you to lose one attack dice.
Yes.
Range one, the Grand Inquisitor goes, I'm at range one. I gain a green dice.
I'm at range one, you also lose an attack dice, but it's at the range three where Addy goes, you're at range three. But I get to turn my shot to a range one, which I haven't done here. But I got 2 hits and I get one through, so not too bad. But yeah, they've got very similar abilities that can get quite confusing when you're looking at them, but off that exchange, both taken a damage.
So potentially, there's like never a range one shot in this. Like, there's never going to be a true range one shot unless people run out of force.
Essentially, yeah. If people run out of force, then...
It's weird to think about.
it really is. I'm the only one that can get a range one by not being at range one. Essentially. So, but again, these two ships are nippy as well. They've got a really good, fun, in-close dial. Obviously, I've got that.
The two ships are of different factions. These two pilots are very similar.
Yeah.
They're both 2 force, 4 health ships with 3 agility, 2 attack. Very similar abilities as we've already gone over.
Yeah.
And the dials as well.
Yeah, their dials aren't too dissimilar. They've got obviously slight tweaks to it, talons instead of S loops. But yeah, they're very close, and their action bars, I'm just having a look now, again, very similar with a purple evade for the Delta 7 rather than a white that I have.
In an interesting way, I feel like is quite thematic because the Inquisitors were, at least to my knowledge, mostly former Jedi, to have their ship be a Jedi starfighter effectively.
Yeah, most of them were. I mean,
I know the Inquisitor was a guard, spoiler for Rebels.
Yeah, and I believe Adigalia may have become... I'm not sure, may have become an Inquisitor.
I don't know enough about her to say for sure. I will have a quick Google now.
Yes, if you can, that would be good, because people have mentioned it. I'm terrible at remembering that, but looks like we've got... a range 2 shot here from Addy in the bullseye. So getting that focus. Does Addy spend both force to try and get it through? I mean, it'll be a hit double crit, so that could be huge. He's spending it, and I don't disagree.
I mean, double crit could be absolutely brutal.
Oh, but there is the evade and the focus results, so spending force by
those 3 defense dice.
Yeah. So that worked out good for myself. The force on the overlay is not correct, because I would admit I was obviously doing this all at the same time as playing. Now it's up to date, which is good. But that was unfortunate for Wes, very lucky for me. That could have been brutal.
So I'm just scrolling through her Wikipedia page. She's done a lot. She's done a lot more than I thought. I'm still scrolling. Hang on.
She's probably one of those ones that appeared quite a few times in, I reckon, Clone Wars that didn't realize. There's quite a few
things in the show, yeah.
But that's a cheeky little bank from Addy there. Let's see what the Grand Inquisitor does. Who, again, in the TV shows, is an incredibly cool character, especially in Rebels. Very, very, very imposing. Had that right level of sort of like menace, but not too much that was over the top for a kid's show. Just waiting on Wes's action.
She was not an Inquisitor. She got killed by Vader at some point.
Oh, fair enough. That's almost a bit of a shame. It would have felt nice because of the abilities. But here we go for the 2 Talon.
Oh, apparently she was one of the voices that Rey hears in Rise of Skywalker.
Oh, cool.
It's an obscure one.
There's so many voices in there.
And maybe part of a novelization. Or because it's a voice I don't recognize. Anyway.
So, we have the Talon.
We have another non-range 1 round.
Oh, and I have spent the force to say no, range 1-0. Which, again, this really fails me. Obviously, I don't have any other defensive mods.
Oh.
That's 2 blanks. He's got the lock, though.
I mean, you may as well.
I don't see any reason.
You're only going to have 2 attack dice in this anyway.
Yeah. And that's 2, so that is big. Now here's the dilemma. Oh, spending right. it. Spending
so because it. You spend it, you now can't. What, instinctively?
I think I can't instinctively, but I'm not entirely sure. I should have bullseye, I think, but I'm not entirely sure.
I think because, you said you have to check after.
Oh, no bullseye. So, then. Yeah, definitely the right call.
Because whilst you don't need the lock or whatever you need to fire it, you do still need the right arc.
Yeah, and you also still need health to go through the game.
Also that.
Tip, guys, if your ships have no health, you've probably lost.
Or you're that one Grand Ocean slave ship that comes back, whose name I'm forgetting.
Morallo?
There might be Morallo, yeah.
Yeah. That's a cool one. I like that. We had that in the large ship Aces High, where someone had one of those. Ship. Yeah, flew it off the board just for fun.
Yeah.
The 2 bank did. Was that? No, that was the 2 sloop that didn't fit.
It's never good when you bump on a red move.
Yeah. It does feel bad, and it's. I'm actually really happy with that because it allows me to move away and set up. So yeah. Now I've got the lock, and I've got decent space there to Talon if I want to. Or, I mean, you can see what I'm about to do because where I'm obviously hosting this. It's your
perspective that's the recording, so we can see a little bit more than usual.
though, but yeah, looks like I am going to be doing the Talon, which, you know what, isn't too bad. Gets me positioned nicely to come back in. And again, we've already said, the Grand Inquisitor has a really good dial.
Like, plus, you know that Adigalia is not going to be facing you if you sit there. Oh. Yeah. Oh, that's...
Now, this is one of those moments where I was just like, not like this.
Was that the wrong direction?
That was the wrong direction. Yeah. And I literally turned around to Wes and said, nope, I am not having that. Put it the right way. Because, you know, that's definitely not... Like,
when all that's on the line, really, at the end of the day, is bragging rights.
Yeah. And whilst this is a tournament, as it were, is a competition and we want to win, it's still about having fun. Yeah. There's nothing worse than flying a ship off the board. I mean, if it was like a grand tournament or a Worlds and someone flew off the board,
if it were the case that you had cornered them and like you blocked out most of their positions and they like just managed to go over the edge trying to get
I'd ionize them into position they couldn't. Yeah.
But something like, oh, I dialed in the wrong direction. Yeah. Let's go back on it.
On a tournament,
I feel like most people playing at a table with their friends would allow that.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, if it was top table at Worlds and it was the final and someone did that, I'd probably be a bit like, well, that's a bit unfortunate, isn't it, buddy?
I mean, if I'm at top tables at Worlds, I'm wondering, how did
I'm pinching myself. I am pinching myself. And then wondering how many text messages I got from the missus going, where the hell are you? yeah, I just popped to the shop for a little bit. 5 days later, where have you been, America?
I mean, you've got a lot of room to set up here.
Yeah. Both of us have a nice amount of room to set up. Obviously, I'm stressed, but probably... I wasn't even looking at my dial there. I was when I was playing, but not just then. Probably just a one hard in.
One, maybe a two, but probably a one.
Probably the one. The two's white, if I remember rightly. I should double check that. I'm not great at knowing the dials off the top of my head.
Oh, Addy went for a boost. Okay. Wes playing fairly aggressively here. Like, he's not going for any kind of defensive tokens.
I mean, aggressive... When you've only got 20 minutes, as you know, sometimes you do just have to go for the aggression.
Yeah, plus I suppose with the ability that she has, then you can't rely on that for the defense.
Yeah.
Oh, just clips the bullseye, though.
Oh, that's not good.
Well, it's not good for you. It's great for Wes.
No.
Plus, it's range one.
Well, gonna be spending a force to turn that off then.
Yep. But it does mean you have one less force.
Yes, there is that.
So that focus down there is the laser targeting. So roll these two. Oh, that's
unfortunate. Win. And no target lock for Wes. That's my target lock.
He goes for the crit anyway. So there is a crit, but you do spend your force to stop it.
Yeah, I think even though I've got the shield, I still spend it.
Oh yeah, yeah, because you'd be giving up half points.
Yeah, which is no. So I now have the range one, which again, Wes could turn off, which he has.
Spend the lock. Oh no, fire control system. Sorry.
Fire control system, hit crit. Nice. And... Oh, it's a focus
one crit gets
That's through. A crit going through, which does give me the half points, and the crit is...
Is it a direct hit?
It's a weapons failure.
Oh. Oh, that's...
Oh,
that's
no, sorry, really... structural damage.
Okay, that's not as bad.
Yeah, structural damage, not great. Weapons failure, awful.
I was going to say, weapons failure on a two-attack die ship is terrible.
Yeah, that is honestly the worst.
By losing an evade on
a three-way ship is
not as bad. It's always annoying as the attacker, though, when you get structural damage on something like a ghost or a decimator. It's like, oh no, I've gone from zero agility down to zero agility. And you just sat there going,
yeah, I mean, structural damage on one of those ships, a fuel leak or a hull breach when it's the last hull point left.
Yeah, when it's the last little bit. It's like, direct hit.
Disable power regulator when a ship's already ionized.
Yeah.
What's the point?
I don't think I've seen that happen too many times, though.
No, it's... I don't think I've ever actually seen it, but...
Yeah. Okay, so what is happening here? We got...
Power regulator on a ship that's already ionized, that has already shot. Does that mean they do the ion maneuver and then get it, or does it clear when they do the ion maneuver anyway?
I think it will clear as soon as they do any ion maneuver.
I think that's not bad.
Oh, Wes has gone...
hyper aggressive.
Yeah, is that obstructed or is that just snuck around it?
It is unobstructed with only three dice being pulled down. Okay. That is.
And you know what, with the timer, I don't know, because if he gets half points, we'll be going to another round. So we'll.
Yeah.
But it's all on Wiz to take a shot. Spends the force.
Oh, and there is the evade. So that keeps that shield up. So spending the force to get the shield up was beneficial there. That does give me the win.
So that gives this time, you 4 full points.
3 points because no kill.
Oh, no kill. So not enough.
Not enough to make it to the top cut, so that does mean that Wes and Ben, with their 7 points, do make it to the top cut. And for those of you in my first game, yes, I know it was really bad. I didn't see that stress, but it didn't affect the overall results. And because they have the same points, we look at their head-to-head results. Wes beat Ben both times. He will go through as the top seed from Group 1, looking to face the pilots from Group 2 who make it through, which we'll find out next week. But that was a very cagey game, and evades were the order of the day. They saved my bacon there with the Force, so I'm turning off Range 1 every so often. That was powerful for both ships.
Yeah, that's still an odd situation to have different players doing that, but good game to both players in this one.
Thank you, and yeah, well done Wes for making it to the top cut, as well as Benji. And James, really good to have you back on. We'll see how you get on next week with the remainder of Group 2, but I hope you enjoyed that one.
Yes, no, it's been great. Thanks.
Excellent. And guys, again, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next time.